We're going to go ahead and call our meeting to order. This is our July 14th, 2016 City Commission meeting. We want to thank everybody for coming out tonight. We're going to have our invocation by Reverend Vern Harkey, DD Interim Pastor, First Baptist Church of Palatka. Reverend Harkey, would you please come forward? Followed by Reverend Harkey, we're going to ask Jake Johnson if he would lead us in the pledge.
Let's pray together, please. Father, I thank you for the privilege of being able to come here tonight and pray for my hometown. Father, you've given us a beautiful place. But Father, help us to realize that the greatest resource that we have here in our town is not our river or our land. It's our people. And Father, we thank you for people who live in this community. And we thank you for these city commissioners and those who work for the city who work to make this place a better place. Now, Father, grant to these leaders compassion. Help them to remember, Father, that the decisions that they make affect people's lives for good and for ill. Father, grant to them understanding. Give them the ability to discern. Father, grant to them wisdom. Help them, Father, not only to know what they know, but Father, help them to understand in their hearts so that our hearts manage our minds and always attach that degree of love that we need. Father, in these days of confusion and anxiety across our country, I would pray especially, Father, that we would love one another. Not that we're always going to agree with one another, but that we would will the best for our fellow man, that we would be willing to do whatever it takes in order to be sure that the other person has what they need. Father, we thank you that you love us that way. And help us to remember that our love will not be because of who we are or just the decisions we make. It will come because we have allowed Jesus Christ to live in our hearts. Father, I ask you to bless these leaders and bless our community and bring unity and harmony and concern and care for one another so that it might be the hallmark of who we are as Palatka. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Salute. Pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Roll call, please.
Mayor Hill.
Here.
Vice Mayor Brown.
Present.
Commissioner Borum.
Present.
Commissioner Campbell.
Present.
Commissioner Norwood.
Here.
All members are present and accounted for, and you have a quorum.
Thank you. Has everyone had an opportunity to look at the minutes from our 6/23/16 meeting?
Second.
There's a motion and second on the floor. Is there any unreadiness?
Question.
Questions called. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, motion carries unanimously. We'll now move on to item one of our agenda, which is our public recognition and presentation section.
Good
The first item up is a recognition of for our alternate delegate for the American Legion Boys State Convention. That honoree is here today. We want to take an opportunity to recognize him publicly. And that young man's name is Nathaniel Miller Jr. And so we want to ask Mr. Miller to come forward at this time, along with the representatives from the American Legion. And we'll be remiss if we don't recognize our superintendent, who's also here now, and ask her to come up. It's Chris Well. And I'm gonna make this real easy. This time I'm gonna have a representative from the American Legion talk a little bit about Mr. Miller, and then I'll close up. And so we'll do it a little different this time. So
that would be Mr. Owens.
Thank you very much, Mrs. Worthy. Commissioners and all, I will try to make this brief. But I do thank you for recognizing this fine young gentleman that we represented Putnam County in Tallahassee for 6 days and at the 73rd year of the American Legion National Program of Boys States. We do have a Girl States too, by the way, so I don't want to forget that. Thank you. That's a different week though. Nathan was picked as one of four finalists, which we had to narrow down to two for financial reasons. But we hope to expand it next year. And we could use any help and donations and anyone that would like to partner with us to send some more. I'm going to let Nathan tell you about what it's all about. But as I said, it's the 73rd one. It's a national program. Several notable people have attended over the years. Most notable probably is Bill Clinton. And you can see he stayed in politics. So. I also want to thank the staff of the school system and the school superintendent, Ms. Phyllis Criswell. She orchestrated in the background here, and her staff and principals were able to narrow it down to four. And we almost couldn't narrow it down any farther, too. There are four great gentlemen that they sent us. And so we had to pick, we were only able to get two, originally one, but we were able to get a little more financing, we were able to send two. And you did the honor of honoring the other candidate, Owen Meeks, before they left for camp. Owen's not with us tonight because he's in Alabama. He's spending the summer there at a missionary camp learning to be a missionary, one of his goals in life. But right now, I'd like to turn it over to Nathan.
Thank you. Boys State was an outstanding experience, and I've learned a great deal about government in Florida, and I'm very thankful to Ms. Criswell and my principal, Ms. Higginbotham, my parents and my teachers for the support, and the American Legion Post 45 for giving me the opportunity to go. It was an outstanding experience, and I met many great people, and I'm glad to have the opportunity to go. Thank you.
Nathaniel Miller is one example of what's right with Putnam County School District. He is an amazing young man, and you will see him in the future. He may be vying for your job or one of your jobs. And if we're lucky, that's what will happen, because we need a bright future, and that's what he represents. He is truly incredible. And when we narrowed down to four young men, and he was one of the four, we had trouble doing that. But he is the cream of the crop, and he is our future, and we are very proud of him. Thank you, Nathan, and your family for being here today.
Before I forget, and there's an interesting story that goes along with this, I want to make sure I recognize your parents and your family that's here with you today. So if you guys can stand up, because this couldn't be done without him, without you guys. It was a pleasant surprise to see them walk into the room Nathaniel Sr. He's also, that's my stepdad's brother. He's been an uncle to me. He's been a part of raising me. And so when I saw them walk in here, and I've seen him for many years, but I didn't put the correlation together when I saw the name on the calendar simply because it was Crescent City. But I want to tell you that I've looked over the things that you've done. I've seen you since you were a little kid. It's been a long time since I've seen you. But you're a drum major. And as a drum major, you're a leader. And you exemplify what a leader should be in this community. We're all proud of you. The city of Palatka is especially proud of you. Putnam County is proud of you because you represent us. And we look for great things out of you in the future. And we just want to thank you for the steps that you've taken thus far. And as a representative, we want to make sure that you never go without being recognized. We want to present you with the city from when the picture of Penn, the city of Palatka. And thank you for all your efforts. Yeah, family wants to come up. We can take a picture along with representatives here as well. Again, Nathan, we're absolutely thankful. We're thankful for you. Give it up again for our drum major.
We have to go over and meet at 7 o'clock.
Yes, sir. And as they rush to their seat, one of the things that actually stood out most was his commitment to the community. When you look at his statements and his passions, one of the things that he said that he would do if he was governor was start to deal with litter in our community. And so that you know, our commission, our city has been really at the forefront of the things that we do as it relates to litter. And it's kind of a great segue. We just recently had a countywide cleanup, which was the Great Putnam Cleanup in conjunction with several different community partners, including Keep Putnam Beautiful. One of our other partners was Road Heavers Boys Ranch. And so our second recognition, we collected almost 10,000 pounds of trash in one day. We had over 500 volunteers throughout the entire county come forward. And at this time, I want to go ahead and call up the representatives from Road Heavers Boys Ranch. I'm going to also ask that Mr. Holmes come forward and help me present this. And again, I want to thank you guys for volunteering Jake to lead us in the pledge and then accompanying him. But there's not enough that we can say when our young people pitch in and start to do things in our community. And we want to make sure that we take this time to recognize you guys. And so we've got a Distinguished Community Service Award. And this certificate of appreciation is awarded by the City of Palatka Commission to BSA Troop 337 and Cub Scout Troop 337. Road Heavers Boys Ranch, Clean It Up, Green It Up, Countywide Cleanup. And grateful recognition for your support and contribution by participation in this public-private partnership to enhance the natural beauty of Palatka and Putnam County, awarded this 14th day of July, 2016. Terrell Hill Mayor, Mary Lawson Brown, Rufus Borum, Justin Campbell, James Norwood Jr., Commissioners, Terry Suggs, City Manager. I can tell you when we were talking about the cleanup, I spoke to Mr. Holmes, and I know that Mr. Holmes is one who works very closely with the Boys Ranch. It is near and dear to his heart, and it is a wonderful program in this community for our young men. And Mr. Holmes, I want you to go ahead and maybe say a few words about the accomplishments of these young men, and then we'll turn it over from there.
Well, I think everyone in the community, probably most everyone, should know the Boys Ranch. It's a private, nonprofit facility located south of Palatka. They house between 45 and 50 boys and provide home to those boys, schooling, home, a home-like atmosphere. until the boys can go to a different setting. Some stay until they're 18 and graduate from high school. Some are able to go back to their own homes. We're very proud of the job that Ken Johnson, who's executive director of the ranch, and the staff do. I've personally been gratified and proud to be part of working with the ranch, mainly because of the reward that you have from dealing with fine young men who, for one reason or another, have needed a different set of surroundings in their life, and they come to us, and I've been nothing but impressed with them and their willingness to help in whatever way they're asked. I guess in this particular cleanup, how many did you have assist in that? 44 kids helping on a hot day to pick up trash. We have a couple of scout programs at the ranch. We're proud to say that we have how many Eagle Scouts now we had it through the ranch?
Through the years?
Yeah.
20 years, been about 16.
16 Eagle Scouts through the troop there at the ranch. So I'm happy to see them. Anything that we can do to publicize the work that the ranch does, from my perspective, is a positive. As I say, they get no funding from any public source of any sort. The funding that we get comes from donations, and it is a working ranch, and so what they're able to generate on their own, and then, of course, the generosity of others. So some of you don't know about the ranch. If you have an opportunity to go out and visit, we have a Bluegrass Festival, I guess, coming up in October. It'll be the next big event at the ranch. You're welcome to go out, and if you contact me and you want a tour of the ranch, we'll give you one, and you can understand a little bit more about what goes on out there. So I'll appreciate the mayor giving me an opportunity to speak about something that is near and dear to my heart. And Mr. Johnson and his staff, they do all the work along with the boys. Some of us in the community are fortunate enough to help a little bit as we can, but the real work is done out there by Mr. Johnson and his staff and the boys themselves.
Johnson.
We thank you for this opportunity. The mayor asked me to say something about the programs out there. First of all, our education program, we get on a school bus every day just like everybody else, and we go to school, go to public school. We actually go to the elementary school. We have the junior high or the middle school and the Palatka High School, and the boys participate just like anybody else. They have sports programs, music programs, whatever. Actors, you know, when it comes to the plays and things like that, you know, we've distinguished ourselves over the years with this. We also have Boy Scout Troop 337 and Cub Pack 337 out at the Boys Ranch available. We have a horse program. We have a work programs. We have contracts with the state, you know, to actually bring in income for the ranch, and we enjoy what we do. Have 790 acres, 5 cottages, up to 10 boys per cottage. And we stay busy 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, and we appreciate your support and we appreciate your prayers.
Now, before we sit down, can we get each one of you just to introduce yourself so that everyone here would know? Because we definitely want to thank you personally for the things that you do. Can we just get you to introduce yourself?
My name is Jacob Allen Johnson. I am a senior at Palatka High School. I am an honor roll student. I am currently 16 years old and have been at the ranch since I was 12. And I've been there the longest, actually.
My name is Michael Reeser. I am also an honor roll student at enrolled at Palatka High School. I will be a junior at the start of this year. And I've been at the ranch for about 2 years now.
Hello, my name is Bobby Wilson, and I'm 16. I'm going to be a junior this year at Palatka High, and I've been at the ranch for just about 4 years.
So again, we want to thank these guys for coming out, for participating in our cleanup, countywide cleanup. Good friend of mine, Titus O'Neill, one of my frat brothers, grew up at the ranch over in Suwannee County. And he's now a WWF superstar, but he's a great guy, and it's a testament to the work that people like Mr. Holmes and Mr. Johnson do, and the love that you guys have and the growth that you experience. And so we thank you for all that you do in this community. I want you guys to keep it up and continue to move forward, okay? Thank you very much.
And we like to take our time with our public recognitions, especially when we're recognizing young people in this community. There's very few opportunities that you have to really to fertilize and cultivate the most precious resource that we have, and that's our young people. You know, when we see young folks like the Rock Fellowship here, and we see that group. And Rock, just go ahead and stand up for me while you're here. These young folks work, they work overtime in our community. And any service event that we have, it seems like we're going to at least get a few representatives from Rock. And we thank you guys for all that you do. We look forward to working with you during the summer. We got some summer jobs starting now. And so we just want to tell you guys thank you. They've been with us all day long, from interviews to they sat in on the budgeting process. They were definitely the youngest people in the audience, and they're still here for the commission meeting. And so we thank you for, and we look forward to everything that you guys do. Now we're going to move into our public comment section. Public comment will be limited to 3 minutes. If you want to speak during public comment, there are speaker cards in the back of the room next to Mr. Vickers. Fill out your speaker card, and we will, the items of the topics of discussion, there will be no action taken on those topics, but we will listen diligently. First person up, who's next to the cards, Mr. Askew Vickers. You will hear our Southern Belle when you get close to 10 seconds for everyone, so that you'll know that I just need you to wrap up your thought and so we can move forward. I'm pretty lenient with the time some days.
Oh, you're on my time.
We'll go from there. No, your time hasn't started yet. So that was part of my 3 minutes. So I've got 2 minutes and 15 seconds left. Askew Vickers.
Okay, good evening. Askew Vickers, 207 North 18th Street, Palatka. And I first would like to commend these commissioners for a good job they're doing. And especially for our chief of police, doing a great job. And as the mayor spoke just a few minutes ago, about our youth are our future. And we have to invest into our youth so they can come forth and do the same job or even a better job than we all are doing. But we are here to discuss some issues that I look up to see that need to be addressed. The first thing I'd like to say, and I've said it before, that there's something called the working poor versus the non-working, wealthy, and rich people. The wealth comes from the poor that's going up to the rich people, and they trickle down a little bit. And that goes as far as I'm concerned, where I'm going with this, is that the golf course and the airport, those two in places are like cadavers. They're on life support. Cadavers on life support mean that they are never going to do anything. They are dead. And you all still got life support hooked up to them. Somewhere along the line, you have to cut this loose, because I don't know who gains from the airport. The golf course has been a loser for God knows how long. Even God don't remember how long it's been losing money. But there's a thing that something has to be done. The next thing I would like to talk about is that we have a thing that the commission come up with. They want to have an impact fee for people building houses. We can't go back in the past and look at all the things, the bad things that the commission has done. Our previous commissioners did a lousy job of what they were doing. Just imagine that you're going to charge somebody $10,000 to build a house. And the one commissioner said, oh, just add to their to the bill. They'll pay it. But when it comes up, when they have to pay a fire tax, they can holler about that. So we can't be concerned about the past anymore. We have to go on forward to the future and try to see if we can do something about those cadavers that y'all have life support hooked up to. That's only two of them. There are some more. So my time is going to be up, so I'm going to let you know, I'll ring the bell.
You got 30 seconds. For the record, Mr. Vickers yields the remainder of his time to me.
I had some more to say last week.
We always welcome Mr. Vickers here. He's been a business owner for almost 50 years now, right? How long has it been? How long has it been since you've been in existence?
In the place I am now?
Yes, sir.
40 years.
Mm-hmm. So our next speaker is Zenaria Ware. Did I say your name right?
Zenaria.
I was close. They mess mine up too sometimes. Ms. Brown is the main culprit. Say your name and address for the record, please, ma'am.
Zenaria Ware, 506 North 22nd Street, apartment C174. I thought now?
Yes, okay. Ma'am.
I just wanted to, on behalf of my peers, I wanted to say thank you because I remember last year when we were helping you with your campaign and Commissioner Campbell with your campaign. You guys was promising the youth that you guys would have something for us to do because we wanted more recreational, because we were bored and we felt like there was nothing here in Palatka for us. And I believe that you guys have, you know, lived up to your promises, and you know, with the internships and the internship with PAL and stuff like that. So I would like to thank y'all, you know, for keeping your promises and doing a great job.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you. For the record, she did not contribute. But again, it's always good for our young people to come up, and we look forward to creating new opportunities and molding people. And so we just thank you guys for being here. And we thank you for the comments. Is there anyone else here for public comment? Ray Starnowski.
Ray Skarbowski, 105 West St. John's Terrace. But I just want to say that since the first time coming here, you sense the Spirit of God working among you, especially with that prayer that was there. I would ask that you start carrying handkerchiefs or Kleenex boxes, because the greatest resource of Palatka, I thought, was the harbor and this. It is the people. And that pastor hit it right on. And then what happened here, everyone mentoring to these children, that is the greatest resource we have, that the people plus the resource God gave us in Palatka. But on the resurrection of the tombs out there, I've been going around, and I took my grandson, 3-year-old and 6-year-old, out to Palatka Airport. I took him one time. My other grandson, 16, is blind, so they allowed us to go in a cart and touch the airplanes and everything, and it was quite impressive to him. So I just went out last weekend with my 3-year-old and 6-year-old. They allowed me to go on the cart and just take them, but said, don't touch it. But then after we were done, the man says, you know, children could be educated out there. So resurrecting something in the name of Jesus, something like that, could give some education on aeronautics for the parachute people that are doing it. It's impressive to the children. The other thing is the golf course. I went over there and I seen, and it was here and there, it's going to do something, but resurrecting it, the pool's back there. Why not have a swimming area for even adults? The pool, put a couple of more pools in. That would attract people to cool them down with weather like this. But using the sites we have instead of tearing, reuse them, recycle them. But agree with you that you guys are all doing a great job. I really appreciate you, and continue touching the hearts as you're doing things. And the words that come from your mouth, may they be seasoned that everyone benefits from it and giving God the glory of it. So thank you.
Thank you. Is there anyone else here for public comment? Seeing no one here for public comment, we'll go ahead and close public comment at this time. We'll move on to item three of the agenda, which is consent agenda. We've got four items on the consent agenda. Item A is to adopt resolution number 2016-12-44, authorizing execution of an amendment number 2 to the contract for purchase of sale with Riverfront Development Group LLC for redevelopment areas 1 and 2. B, grant permission to exceed allowable noise levels for special events permit number 16-05. Founders Day, July 23rd, 2016, from 8 a.m. to 6 p.m. To God be the glory, Holiness Church, applicant, Fayward agent. C, introduce Form 8B Memorandum of Voting Conflict into the record filed by Commissioner Justin Campbell on a vote taken 6-23-16 on agenda item number 9. D, introduce Form 8B Memorandum of Voting Conflict into the record filed by Commissioner James Norwood Jr. on a vote taken 6-23-16 on agenda item number 9. Are there any items on the consent agenda that need to be removed at this time? There's a motion to approve.
Second.
There's a second by Commissioner Campbell. Any discussion?
Questions?
Question has been called. All in favor say aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries unanimously. Moving on to item number 4 is a resolution establishing a sister city agreement with Jersey City, New Jersey. I'll take the lead on this item. And I will tell you, in the last 2 weeks ago, Central Academy High School, class of 1954, had a class reunion of sorts. Unlike most people, not doing a year that is a multiple of 5. But they had a large number of people here in town, but one individual stuck out more than others, and that was Henry Norford. And Henry Norford is a commissioner on the rent leveling committee in Jersey City, New Jersey. He reached out a few months ago, and although he moved to New Jersey many decades ago, his love for Palatka has continued to be in place. And he gave a commitment that he wanted to have Jersey City forever be connected to his home, to his hometown. And so Mr. Norfolk worked diligently on getting the mayor of Jersey City to provide to pass a resolution that establishes a sister city agreement with the city of Palatka. And that resolution reads as follows. Whereas the city of Palatka, located in Putnam County, Florida, is situated on the lower portion of the St. John's River Basin and is known as the gem of the St. John's River. And whereas the city of Palatka was first established as a trading post in 1821 and is now home to 10,483 residents, as well as the St. John's River State College and Ravine Garden State Park. And whereas the city of Palatka is rich in cultural history and is famous for the annual Blue Crab Festival, as well as the annual Florida Azalea Festival. Whereas the city of Palatka has actively worked to preserve its history, particularly its rich heritage in the railroad industry. The Palatka Railroad Society was created in 1993 for the preservation of the city's railroad history and that of the surrounding communities. And whereas coupled with the interest in the preserving its heritage, the city of Palatka launched a successful mural program in early 1998 administered by the Connolly Snyder Mural Committee, which depicts the cultural diversity and the natural landscape of the city and instills pride in its local citizens. And whereas the city of Jersey City, cognizant of all the great things that are happening in the city of Palatka, wishes to establish a sister city relationship with Palatka, Florida. Now therefore, be it ordained that the Municipal Council of the City of Jersey City does hereby establish a sister city agreement with Palatka, Florida, and looks forward to many years of cultural, educational, governmental, and recreational exchange. Attested, Joyce Waterman, Council at Large, Daniel Rivera, Council at Large, Frank Gajewski, Council Ward A, Richard Bagiano, Council Ward C, Michael Young, Councilman Ward D, Candace Osborne, Councilman Ward E, Diana Coleman, Councilman Ward F, Robert Byrne, City Clerk, Orlando R. Lavaro Jr., Council President. And this was adopted by Jersey City for the city of Palatka. I've got a copy of this for all our commissioners so that you can have it for your records. They also sent over a pin from the city of New Jersey from the city of Jersey City, signed by Mayor Stephen Fuller. And we have that, and we will present this and keep it in our records.
So we need to make a motion to, do we need to reciprocate, send them a resolution from us to do so?
Well, we do need to reciprocate. And Ms. Striggers, can you please read the proposed resolution that we have at this time?
Can we read it all?
Yes, ma'am.
Resolution number 2016-12-45, a resolution of the City of Palatka, Florida, recognizing and establishing a sister city agreement with the City of Jersey City, New Jersey. Whereas Jersey City, New Jersey is the seat of Hudson County, it being the county's largest city in land mass and population, and is a significant port of entry, being bounded on the east by the Hudson River and Upper New York Bay, and on the west by the Hackensack Bay and Newark Bay, and having significant rail connections. And whereas Palatka, Florida is the seat of Putnam County, it also being the county's largest city in land mass and population, and was formerly a significant port of entry for the state of Florida, being bounded on the east by the St. Johns River and having significant rail connections. And whereas the area now known as Jersey City was once inhabited by Native American tribes and was first established as a territory by the Dutch West Indies Trading Company in 1621. It was first incorporated as the City of Jersey by the State of New Jersey in 1829, and after several incorporations, was finally incorporated into what is now the City of Jersey City in 1870. Whereas, similarly, the City of Palatka was first a Native American settlement, as described by William Bartram in his writings on his travels, and was established as a trading post in 1821, later being charted as the town of Palatka in 1849, and then the city of Palatka in 1853. And whereas Jersey City has a historic downtown situated on the waterfront, as does Palatka, which is home to many cultural attractions, stores and restaurants, as well as neighborhoods and parks, which has recently undergone gentrification that has seen an improvement in neighborhoods and caused a rise in the standard of living throughout the city. And whereas Jersey City has much to offer Palatka through the establishment of a sister cities agreement, and that Palatka recognize all the great things that have happened in Jersey City by the resurgence of its downtown, neighborhoods, commerce, and industries. And whereas the City of Jersey City, New Jersey, has adopted a resolution establishing a sister city relationship with the City of Palatka, Florida, and the City Commission of the City deems it an honor and a privilege to acknowledge and establish this relationship. Now, therefore, be it resolved by the City Commission of the City of Palatka, Florida, that the City of Palatka does hereby accept the establishment of a sister city agreement with Jersey City, New Jersey, and looks forward to many years of cultural, educational, governmental, and recreational exchange. Passed and adopted by the City Commission of the City of Palatka, Florida, this 14th day of July, 2016, by Mayor Terrell Hill, Vice Mayor Mary Lawson Brown, Commissioner Rufus Borm, Commissioner Justin Campbell, Commissioner James Norwood, Jr., and we've got it all signed and sealed.
Motion for approval.
This is a motion to approve and a second on the floor. Any discussion?
Motion.
Questions called? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries unanimously. Again, we want to make sure we send a special thanks over to Commissioner Norfolk for his work in establishing the sister city relationship with Jersey City. It's always good to have citizens reach back once they've left and not forget about home.
You want to send a copy of that to Mr. Norfolk?
I will send a copy of it to Mr. Norfolk along with the mayor, and we will try to truly engage in a relationship with Jersey City. I think the ties to the railroad, when you look at the history of A. Philip Randolph, they become significant for us to actually move forward on some projects.
Well, we had the Bartram Trail, and we were Indian Reservoir. I mean, this has been an Indian area, so we have a lot in common.
There's a rich history here, and I think it's time that we continue to let people discover what Palatka is truly about.
Maybe look into maybe some other cities that might be interested. We do have another city, sister city in Russia called Palatka, Russia. We were talking about it years ago because we thought we might be able to do international business. But it's in Siberia, and it did not have a product that was sellable in the United States.
If we stand where Sarah Palin was, then we can actually see Russia. So we're going to now move on to item 5 of the agenda, resolution confirming and accepting the rankings of proposals received from Wastewater Treatment Plant Improvements, RFP 2016-007, and authorizing contract negotiations.
A resolution of the City of Palatka, Florida, accepting the ranking of proposals for third-party sludge processing and treatment and disposal systems and services at the Wastewater Treatment Plant.
Motion for approval.
There's a motion on the floor and a second. Now, before we move forward, we're open the floor up, Mr. Griffin.
Yes, sir. Jonathan Griffith, Public Works Director. I think all of you are aware that we put this out to RFP a couple months ago. We wanted to make sure that it wasn't a single source provider and there wasn't any other advantageous options out there. The city received 3 responses. Out of the 3, myself, Brian McCann, and water treatment plant operator Melvin Register reviewed the proposals, and the unanimous number one ranking was New Terrace proposal. As it stands right now, it's a $1,619,000 design build agreement. We will be hopefully bringing that agreement back to you very soon. We do want to go ahead and get the process going as far as the loan application, as well as the necessary permits that have to be applied for. And we will be pulling from our continuing services contract to have an engineer advising us as we move through the design approval process. Are there any questions?
Yes. Who will own the permits once we receive them? With the city owning
it? It should be the City of Palatka. Yes.
Okay. Also, have you given consideration also to the order that make us, once you dehydrate sludge, you know, it doesn't have an odor, but if it ever becomes hydrated again, you know, it will produce an odor, so you will probably need some type of system in place in order to address odor issues. Have you guys considered that?
I'd have to defer to, Les or Jim or Brian on that question.
I mean, actually, the system that we'll be installing definitely addresses the odors. Okay. You know, it will practically eliminate. I mean, the only way you'll have odor is if you let it sit there for weeks
right
at a time. So.
Okay, and my last question is, will you all be bringing in some biomass?
That's something we want to discuss anyway to see if it makes any sense to do that. I think this, part of our proposal was that we build we'd entertain building a facility where we would bring it in only if it'd be beneficial to the City of Palatka.
As of right now, as your public works director, I'm fast-tracking just our system.
Right.
Okay. Now, we'll put everything else on the table, but we need to make sure that we go ahead and address the system deficiencies at the plant. But there are plenty of, you know, mutually beneficial opportunities to talk about in the future.
All right. Any other questions from the commission? Any further discussion?
Did he need to come and tell his name and stuff for the record, or it's all right?
He's been there.
He's already.
I know. Been.
Go ahead, just for the record.
It's just last camp with New Terra.
Question.
Questions called. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries unanimously. So at this time, Mr. Kemp, is there anything that you want to say?
No, just thank you very much.
Thank you. Moving forward, we're moving into public hearing now. Item number 6 on the agenda is an ordinance amending Chapter 2, Division 6 of the Code of Ordinances to add a defined contribution component to firefighters' retirement plan per Florida Statute 175.351, Section 6, first reading.
An ordinance of the City of Palatka, Florida, revising Chapter 2, Division 6 of the Code of Ordinances of the City of Palatka, Florida, entitled Firefighters' Retirement Plan to add a defined contribution component pursuant to the requirements of FS, Florida Statute 175.3516, providing for severability and providing an effective date.
So moved.
Second. Motion on the floor in a second. We're now open the floor for public hearing. Is there anyone here for public hearing? Seeing no one, we will close public hearing. Is there any discussion?
Question.
Questions called. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries unanimously. Moving on to item number 7 of the agenda, ordinance amending chapter 2, division 7, the code of ordinances to add a defined contribution component to the police officer's retirement plan per Florida statutes 185.351, subsection 6, first reading.
An ordinance of the City of Palatka, Florida, revising Chapter 2, Division 7 of the Code of Ordinances of the City of Palatka, Florida, entitled Police Officers' Retirement Plan, to add a defined contribution component pursuant to the requirements of Florida Statute 185.356, providing for severability and providing an effective date.
So moved.
There's a motion on the floor and a second. We'll now move into public hearing. Is there anyone here for public hearing? Seeing no one, we'll close public hearing. Is there any further discussion?
Question.
Questions called. Commissioner Borrell. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries unanimously. Item 8 of the agenda, City Manager and Administrative Reports. Chief Shaw.
Nothing, sir.
Mr. Crow.
Nothing, sir.
Chief Lambert.
Nothing, sir.
Mr. Yule.
Nothing.
Mr. Reynolds.
Nothing, sir.
Mr. Triggers.
No, sir.
Mr. Holmes.
Nope.
Mr. Suggs.
Wow. That got here quick. Well, on the agenda, you see that the fire assessment update, we talked about that earlier today during our budget workshop. I believe everybody's aware. Mr. Reynolds, the mayor and myself met with the Honorable Linda Myers and Honorable Tim Parker earlier this week to discuss this matter of getting on the uniform method of collection. And I believe we have answered all their concerns and we'll be moving forward with utilizing the uniform method of collection. Is that correct, Mr. Reynolds? I believe we've answered their concerns. And Mr. Mayor was instrumental in getting us through the process. I will take the opportunity to tell him personally thank you for attending the meeting with us, and I think it went well, and I believe we're heading in the right direction.
Okay.
Sure, if you want me to go ahead. I'll also, the nice young folks that are here tonight, as we know, we've implemented the youth initiative here in Palatka. We have about probably 12 to 15 applicants. We're going to be starting on Monday with 5 to 6 of these applicants in the first round. They'll be working in various departments here at City Hall, planning and zoning, public works. We'll put them in areas of need. We'll give them an opportunity to get acclimated a little bit to what it is that we do and hopefully continue their public service. It's already been mentioned, they've been here all day. They've been here as well as long as I've been here today. And I think they need to be commended again for that. And we look forward to it. This is just the first round. In about 2 weeks, we'll do round two and continue through the process and try to expose as many of our youth to what it is that we do if we can during the summer program.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Transitioning in, Mr. Campbell.
Again, I just want to thank the commission for allowing me to be one of the figureheads of that internship program. Is something that is truly near and dear to my heart. Having the opportunity to be an intern and then actually being over interns at my previous employment, it was something that I saw the need for. And if any time we can provide guidance or direction to our younger generation, I think it's good that we are on the front end of that. So again, I want to thank each and every one of you all for allowing me the opportunity to oversee that process. The mayor, city manager, and everyone else that took a part in it. Thank you to Rob for being so instrumental in everything that we do. A promise that I did make when I was running was to make sure that we make things to do for our younger kids, and I think that we are doing so. And thank you for acknowledging that we are doing those things. Keeping in mind with that, on Monday, I will be doing adventures with Commissioner Campbell at the River Center. I will be there from 4 to 6, and we're just encouraging families to come out with their children just to explore what we already have here in Palatka. A lot of people, what is that building at the river? So we're doing just things to make sure that we encourage people to utilize the sources and resources that we have here in our city. And that's, again, on Monday from 4 to 6, on the 18th from 4 to 6. Outside of that, just, yeah.
I like my bill. Is that everything?
I suppose. No, that's everything.
See, I waited till you finished before I did it.
No, you did.
Gotta have laughter. Vice Mayor Brown.
I want to say thank you to our staff. They worked really hard to give us a good first budget workshop. And I'm very happy to know that we are not in the red. It doesn't look like we're going to be in the red this time, and it's being worked out. And I want to say thank you to you guys for letting me work with you all. I know it's hard sometimes, but I think that we are beginning to see change and accomplishments, and I hope that we will all continue to work as hard as we've been working to make it much better for everybody. Mayor, I want to thank you for finding Sister Cities. I think it's a wonderful idea.
Thank you. Commissioner Borum.
Yeah, certainly like to thank the staff for the hard work and dedication that they've done throughout the year. I'm very proud to be serving this great community, and it's just a commitment. You can't find better resources than your human resources. You can go out and invest in all the technology you want, but you can't use technology does, decline in value or whatever, but with our human resources, we continue to improve in our human resources. So I'd like to thank all of our dedicated staff. Also, thank Rock for their hard work and dedication and their commitment for staying here. You could have been anywhere else, but you decided to be with the city today, and we certainly applaud your employment here with the city. So we'll be doing everything we can to continue that effort. Thanks.
Commissioner Norwood.
Mayor, I won't be redundant, but yeah, I would just say ditto to the comments the commission has already made, and the thank yous as well. But also want to make sure that we don't forget our cleanup on this Saturday as well. It's going to be in the Rolling Hills as well as the College Arms area. So want to make sure that we get the word out that we're going to be over there cleaning up, doing our like a prior cleanup. And we thank the mayor again too for his leadership in starting that particular program that so that it may continue on and aesthetically make like aesthetically pleasing as well.
I won't take credit for starting it. I'm going to pass that on to Commissioner Brown. Palaka Pride was started there, but I think it's been a collaborative effort in the way that we've moved forward with the program since January. The meeting place for the cleanup is going to be at the City Park on the corner of Hudson Avenue and Edgemore, just in front of the College Arms Apartments. And so we start promptly at 8 o'clock, and we look forward to everyone being there.
She I said, thought y'all said 8:30. You said 8 o'clock.
8 o'clock starts our registration period. Mm-hmm. We actually kick off the cleanup at 8:30. But we start at 8 o'clock for registration. I've got a couple comments. I will not relinquish the bell.
Pass the bell, please.
But we've got some serious things that have happened in this community. Many of you are aware that we had a homicide on last weekend. I want us to take a moment. To have a moment of silence for Rory Davis, gentle giant who lost his life.
Hayward.
It was Davis as well. It was Davis. Rory Davis. Let's take a moment of silence for Rory. Just take an opportunity. Thank you. We want to make sure that we're mindful. That the Palaka Police Department, through the help of some young people, worked very diligently in bringing the suspect to justice and closing that case out with an arrest. We know that anytime there's a death, there's always questions involved as to why. We encourage our citizens to continually look at to allow the Palatka Police Department to continue with its investigation as much as anything is needed for follow-up, and for us to really move forward and be conscious that now we have a family that's grieving, we got a community that's grieving, and we need to make sure that we stand strong with Palatka as Palatkans against violence in our community. There's a banner that sits outside that says that Palatka stands with Florida cities against violence. And we need to continue to do that, and we need other cities to stand with us, but we also need our citizens to stand. This is a rough time. When you look across this country, you look at the things that happen in Dallas, you look at the things that happen in Baton Rouge, it's a perilous time in America, and there are so many things that are separating Americans and keeping us away from just true neighborly love and what this country was built on. Black Lives Matter movement is not the cause of the things that happen in Dallas. People who don't have a consciousness for what life is the cause of that. And we've got to always remember that we can't sit back silently and watch injustices be done to our citizens, to our law enforcement, to our neighbors, because it doesn't take but one incident for it to rest at home. We've got to continue to band together. I've had extensive conversations with Chief Shaw, and the Black Police Department has made significant efforts to engage the community, to inform the community, and I want to personally take this time to thank you guys. We've got Captain Forsythe in the room. We want to thank you, because every day that you go to work is a day that you don't know if you're coming home. And there aren't many people who say thank you enough to you. And we want to take this time to thank you guys for the efforts that you've made. And we want to thank you for continuing to keep this community safe. And we want to thank you for the efforts that you're making in the future to make sure that we understand that everyone in this community matters to you, that we're not going to stand for the injustices that are out there, and that you guys truly care and you're invested in Palatka. So again, guys, thank you for all that you do. Just give them a round of applause. I was talking to one of my line brothers, who's a really good friend of mine. He's an expert as it relates to so many defensive tactics. He's gone all around the world. He's gone all around the world working with law enforcement agencies. He was a former MMA fighter, a PhD in exercise physiology, and he spoke to Chief Shaw and Dr. Ferguson, Dr. Roddy Ferguson, makes significant efforts. He's been summoned by Bermuda and the Bahamas and other countries to come in and teach his tactics to officers. And he's committed to coming to the city of Palatka, reaching back pro bono when he makes mega bucks doing this, to come in pro bono and work with Chief Shaw and the staff so that we can move this community forward. And the chief welcomed him with open arms. They're in dialogue, and we are waiting for that opportunity to come here. He's a 2004 Olympian in jiu-jitsu, and he's willing to come to Palatka, to little Palatka, and just to come in and just to give a part of himself to our officers, and we're glad that people are willing to step forward. We've had parents who talk about the fears that they have raising their children and having to teach them different concepts of how to deal with situations that could become life-threatening. These are real situations for America. They're real situations for Palatka. We've been fortunate that we have men like Chief Shaw and Captain Forsythe, but it's by the grace of God that we're not Baton Rouge, or we're not Ferguson, that we're not Dallas. And we have to continue to educate our people that law enforcement isn't the enemy. They're the guys that protect us and they serve us. And we can't look at a few bad apples as the reasons for why these deaths are occurring, senseless deaths. But we've got to continue to fight for justice for our citizens. We've got to eliminate institutional intolerance, and we've got to move these communities forward. because America is a place where we should not have to deal with the issues that we're dealing with during this day and time. So again, guys, we thank you, we love you, and we're going to continue to support you, and we want to continue to move this community forward so that we don't find ourselves in the situation that some of these other communities are in. On a more positive note, we just came out of our first budget workshop. And when we look at where Palatka is today compared to past years, we're starting to see life back in the veins of what some folks said was a dying city. But we weren't dying, we were resting. And so going from a point where we had about 350,000 in reserves, we've gone up from 5% reserves. We're looking at, we're projected to have over 14% in reserves for the city of Palatka, close to the magic number of 16. We've continued to create jobs. We've continued to move this community forward. We're in a position where we're looking to lower the millage rate again. Having our fire service fee placed on the tax bills through the uniform, and having the uniform method of collection is going to be major for moving Palatka forward, for us being able to put together concrete plans to deal with infrastructure issues. There was a promise made a year and a half ago that we would look at ways to not be the 11th highest city when it comes to ad valorem millage rates. And we're not the 11th highest anymore. There was a promise that if we passed the fire fee, that our citizens would take a hit for the first year, and that we would do everything in our power to lower the millage rate so that there would be an overall reduction for every citizen from the baseline of 2014. When we came in, it was 9.174 mils. That's becoming a reality. We've saved money, we've increased jobs, we've increased efficiency, we're moving Palatka forward, we're investing in our youth. This is what this city is all about. We're now seeing the county and other entities starting to move forward. I don't know what that says. And we're starting to work towards a livable wage for our employees. Our staff, our department heads, have bought in. Job creation, again, for our young people is key. Financial health is key. Palatka's moving forward. And I'm glad to be a Palatkan. I know I've taken a long time, but people always ask us, what have we done? What are we doing? The proof is in the pudding. We're moving this community forward. Sometimes, Chief, I feel like a firefighter because we're always putting out fires. But it couldn't be done without everybody in this room. It couldn't be done without our citizens. It couldn't be done without our folks. And if I can take a few minutes just to brag about Palatka folks, I'm going to take that time, because when the next time a person asks what we're doing, they can roll the tape back, because Palatka is moving forward. We're proud. We've got Senator Nelson's group coming in here. They're bringing in various governmental agencies to see what can be done in this city. And we're excited about what the future holds. We thank again the city manager, as well as Mr. Reynolds, and the efforts that you've made in the proposed budgets, along with the department heads. Everybody is skin in the game, and Palatka's moving forward. With that being said, we are adjourned.